Hello, everyone. My name is Alice. I'm 18 and I have a pretty strange condition. Many of you have probably heard of diseases like diabetes, hemophilia, or ADHD, right? If you have one of those, I'm sure you've had to learn how to live with it. And I'm not here to tell you that your experience is any lesser than mine. But I have something too. It's not common and I'm suffering from it every day. I've suffered every day since I got here. And it's not easy for me to talk about it. I'm actually really ashamed of it, but here goes nothing. This is my story. Everything began 5 years ago when I was just 14. I went out with a few friends for pizza after school to this little restaurant in my hometown of San Francisco. We were having the time of our lives, just eating and messing around with each other and not worrying about anything important, which is what teenagers do. Everything was normal. Then the next day, I woke up with a really, really strong stomach ache. It wasn't like any one that I've had before. This time I felt a really unique pain. Like when you know that you need to throw up to feel better. I squeezed my belly and tried to make myself throw up, but it didn't work. I tried to put my fingers down my throat and touch my uvula, you know, that like weird thing that looks like a boxing bag in the back of your mouth. And finally I threw up, but the pain didn't go away. I realized that my belly wasn't the one messing with me. I woke up my mom and tried to explain to her what was happening, and she immediately took me to the doctor. The pain was so strong that I cried all the way to the office. And we were hitting red light after red light too. Ugh, literally it's like Murphy's Law. After we arrived, a nurse took me to a cubicle and we waited for the doctor. She told me I needed a gastroenterologist to see me. And in case you don't know what that is, that's a doctor that studies your stomach and intestines and stuff. Dr. Robinson got there within a few minutes before I entered the cubicle, but the pain was so strong that it felt like hours for me. He saw that my face was really pale and asked me to take off my shirt and to lower my pants a bit. He started palming my belly very softly until he touched one part and it made me scream out in pain. He didn't even push or anything like that, but I was just so sensitive that barely touching it made me scream. His face changed after seeing my reaction. He started to think a little bit about the situation and then he told the nurse that they needed to do an x-ray as soon as possible. The nurse nodded and pulled me in a wheelchair. The x-ray showed what was happening to me. It wasn't my stomach, it was my colon. That's the part of your body where your poop is before it goes out. Anyways, I hope none of you are eating right now because what comes next could be the grossest thing ever. I had so much poop inside me that it made my colon swell. I needed to go to the bathroom to stop the pain. The thing is that I was constipated and I couldn't poop, and that was the reason why it all started. Dr. Robinson made me sit in the toilet for 10 minutes doing a squat, and that didn't work, so he made me do an enema. I'll explain that too. He took something that looked like a balloon full of water with a pointy end, and he put the end up my butt. Or anus. Yeah, I know anus is a funny word. And then he pressed the balloon very hard so all the water would enter my body. And then I had to wait like 5 minutes before going to the bathroom. The enema helped, and as soon as I pooped, I felt good. It was a huge relief. It seemed like everything was going to be fine now, but then Dr. Robinson made me like a special treatment so it would never happen again. He gave me a big laxative that I needed to drink every day for the next 3 months. The idea was that it would help my colon and I would never get constipated again. That's a weird happy ever after, but I guess it still counts. A month passed, and I was taking it, and I had my first accident. It was a laxative, so naturally it made me go to the bathroom like 3 times a day. And I was starting to have diarrhea, and so I called my doctor and told him about that. He said that I should change the frequency to 4 times a week. The thing is, after that, nothing was the same. 3 trips to the bathroom every day turned to 7, or 10, or even 15 on a really bad day. The doctor performed a bunch of studies to find out what was happening on me, and he had no idea what was going on. I went to other doctors and they all did the same. They performed a bunch of tests and they had the same final answer. I had developed permanent, incurable Brainerd's diarrhea. 5 years of suffering from constant, severe diarrhea. Every doctor will tell you that you need to drink 8 glasses of water a day to stay hydrated. But in my case, I need to drink more than 20 glasses of water or I could dehydrate really quickly. If I drink less than that, I could faint or suffer delusions at the best case. I could die too. I have 25 daily phone alarms and I've never skipped one of them. That's all just to drink water. The worst part is that after 10 times of going to the bathroom, my anus starts to get irritated. So even sitting is a pain in the arse. See what I did there? I'm laughing to not cry. Anyways, this condition has been awful, but my family's always been there for me. They even changed everyone's room around so I could have a bathroom. And my mom also cooks really plain food, like plantains and potatoes and bread, all stuff that's supposed to prevent diarrhea, and sometimes it works. but I can't eat anything like beans or stuff that's gassy, and it just sucks. My friends have also been really helpful at school. Yeah, I still have to go to school like this, and let me tell you what, it's not easy. In the beginning, I wanted to keep it a secret, but after asking to go to the bathroom so many times every single day of the week, people suspected that something was wrong with me. The first person at school that asked me what was going on was a teacher that thought I was addicted to drugs. In his mind, I was taking something like LSD, and that's why I needed to stay hydrated. I told him that I wasn't doing drugs, but as a teacher, he didn't believe me and called my parents. Now, looking back, I think it was the right thing to do. My mom and dad talked about my situation with the school principal, so something like this never happens again. They also tried to ask him to keep it a secret, but like everything at high school, everybody started talking about me as if I was some kind of junkie. So one day I told my classmates the truth. I thought they would bully me for that, but everyone felt sorry for me, so they don't even talk about it. Thank God I go to a private school. I don't even know if I could make it in a normal public school. But even so, it's really been crappy. No pun intended. You know that moment where you feel like you're just gonna fart, but you don't think it's just a fart? Well, it's never just a fart. As soon as I feel something, I have to go to the bathroom, and a lot of times I don't make it on time. I always have a pair of extra panties with me just in case I need them. Every girl has a drawer full of underwear. I have four. I don't even get cute underwear anymore because they're not going to stay cute. No Victoria's Secret for me. My best friend, Ashley, also has some extras on her in case I need them. All my friends try to help me, but as you may figure out, I don't really hang out with them too much because I can't. How can you go to the movies or a party with a condition like this? They usually come to my house to watch TV or movies. They say they love it because they get to pause and it helps them understand the movie better when I have to go to the bathroom. I know that's total bullshit, but it feels nice not to be left out. One day they made me open a Tinder account to find a nice guy. And within a few days of swiping right and left, I matched with this guy named Mark. He's really handsome. And we started chatting and we found out we have a lot of things in common. He insisted that we go out and I agreed only if we went to a place that I knew. He didn't have a problem with that. So we went to a little coffee shop near my house owned by one of my neighbors that knew about me. She gave us a table near the bathroom. Mark and I had an awesome time together. It was my first date ever, and for the first time, I didn't go to the bathroom for like 4 hours. Somehow my body knew how to behave. I couldn't believe it. He walked me home, and before leaving, he kissed me. That was my first kiss, too. As soon as I got in the house, I went to the bathroom, but this time I was happy. I still think of that like one of the happiest days of my life. We've now been dating for 6 months, and I haven't told him about my condition. He always invites me to go to all kinds of plans and parties and things like that, and I always make excuses to not go unless we just go to the little coffee shop. I know he wants to do other things, but he's so nice and he calls the coffee house our special place. And he's not wrong. It's just the only place I can hold myself, and that's really special for me. I'm afraid one day he's going to get tired of me rejecting our plans. I know that all of you might be thinking that I should just tell him the truth and that if he loves me, he'd understand. But what if he doesn't love me enough? Would I feel like this with someone else? I don't think a lot of guys could make me feel like he does, and it's not easy just saying this. I would love to do more things with Mark. I would love to go to the movies, to go to a Giants game, go anywhere, but I just know it would be really difficult for me to do those things. I don't even sleep well at night. I wake up at least 3 times a night, and I'm not sure I can have a special intimate night with Mark. Just thinking about it, like having to stop in the middle of that because I have to poop? What a mood killer. I know he's in love with me, but I'm afraid of the idea of him leaving me after he finds out what's wrong with me. Please, guys, imagine that you're in my position, and please tell me what you would do, because I don't know how many more excuses I can make up to tell Mark. Please help me. I will be reading the comments, and thanks, guys, for listening.